Hello everyone. Today we continue with the next lesson about how to send a parameter using router name and how to define some object with one to many relation. So in the previous lesson, we send to the next we send parameter to the next screen, and I use the router name. The router name means screen name as a way to navigate from this screen to another screen, or this page to another page. Yes, so we must define in the material app, which is we define the initial router. The initial router is a root. Yes, a slash is a root, and the router here, the router property here, and yeah, this is a router name. Value is a function. The function return to the initialization of the destination page. Okay, so we have foot page mean foot page, and category page here a string or a router name mean navigate to the category page. Okay, so foot page is router name, so you don't save like this. Please use a static variable. Let's define a static constant or static variable inside the class. So in footpage class, I define a constant. A static constant mean a fixed value. So I define the router name from the class name. Then I can call to this by simply adding category page dot router name. Okay, class name dot router name. So we replace it with foot page dot router name. Yes, and I run. Okay, so run the program again. Yes. Okay, something wrong with my code because you do not define the this dot category in the foot page. This category in its foot page now is null, so you must add the value to it. So open foot page, and from here I navigate to the okay, so here I define maybe so here, okay, here, so remove. So I set the category property of foot page to the arguments. Now is a map with key and value, and I get the key category from arguments and get the value, means the object of category. So review your application again and click to here. It will show the detail or the list of list of food depending on the category. Okay, so this is a list food according to the category. And what about this? So now I define the model or the list of object. We have a fake food. Fake food mean one category has many food, so it is the array of food objects. In food object, we must have category ID to make sure that the category has many food, and each food is related to a specific category or category ID. So I define the food class. The food class has some property like ID. The ID is random. Random means we have a random value, but not we don't have the two same objects inside a list. So the complexity is enum. Enum is a net enumeration value. We use about three values: simple, medium, and hard. And the duration here is the time, for example, 1 minute, 2 minutes, 15 minutes, etc. And one category has n food, or one category has many food, then one food has many ingredients. So ingredient here is a list of string. So one category has many food. So in food, you must save the property of category ID. The category ID here is a reference to the ID of the category. For example, in category you have food. In category you have fruit or vegetable, and we have many food derived from the vegetable or fruit. So we set the constructor to food. The food constructor has name, URI image is a image of the food, and the duration time to process this food, to do this food, to make this food. The complexity is hard, medium, or simple. And category ID is the category ID for this food. Okay. So the ID is random from 0 to 999. So I use a random function or the random object to save this. So ID here is a random from 0 to 999. So we assign the property this.id is equal to random initialization.nextin. The next in here is 1000. Here is from 0 to 999. So we make some fake food like sushi, URI image, duration, complexity, ingredient, category ID. Yes. And for simplify, you copy the image from the Wikipedia or any other source from the internet. Very easy to copy and paste here. So the complexity, the duration, every food has some properties like here. And yes, we have many food inside my list. And we also have the category list. The category list are binding to the food list. So now I must filter the food from category. For example, one category has many food and we must filter. So to filter, use where. This where function. So we define a food list. First, go to fake food dot where. The where is a function with input a lambda expression. As a lambda expression allow you to filter from the condition. So we only specify the category ID from the list of food, and I convert to string using to string. So here we restart your application, debug your program, and move your mouse here to see the detail object. So for example, we see food. Yes, this is my food list. Click your mouse and see the detail. So we have pizza, Tonna, and Napoleon pizza. Yes, we have two type with a category ID 2. So let's change a little bit. So you can let's add or string the element or the widgets to see the detail. What about the ingredient? No, we firstly display the food list. So we use list view dot builder, and inside this we implement the item builder for every item in the list. So item builder has context and index. The index specify each of the food. Okay, so this is the end of my lesson today. Thank you so much for watching.